Greetings from Indonesia, my name is Pada Kwan, welcome back to Behind the Synfig Arts, or I should say BtSA, number 7. Yeah, number 7, isn't it? Nope, it's actually number 6 right now. And in this BtSA, we're gonna have explore once again on some of my finished Synfig arts and how I create them, how I create in terms of tricks and layering. First of all, let's check on this bead. This is Blooming Memories. As you can see, we have two characters from, well, you guess it, this is from slow start characters. One is Hana Ichinose and the other one is Tamate Momochi, and they are taking selfies. So yeah, again, the inspiration didn't it's not very much reason to do it other than just like, oh, you know what, I should draw something with a different pose, so I should draw characters with different pose and actions. So then I come up with this selfie thingy. And I should say it turned out to be pretty cool, but there are a lot of complicated things along the way. So let's explore that one by one, starting from, I guess, let's go for the hardest part, the background. And now here we are, as you can see, these are the backgrounds as you can really tell from the big picture. There are flowers, gardens. You know, that's why it's called Blooming Memories, because it has blooming flowers. There you go. I don't know how to do some sort of accidental spell on my bad word, or just you know, misspell. Sorry about that. Let's go check out what these flowers actually are and what does it contains and all in all. First of all, you can really see well, there is not much to look at in the first glance, but these flowers are actually made of three different flowers that got transformed and moved slightly different. As you can see, if you check out the group names here, let me just expand it a bit. There are flower 1C, 1A, 1A, 1B, 1B, 1C. There is also 1BK, I don't know, is that... Oh, sorry, that's a flower for flower B. We'll check that out later. These are, you know, it's pretty important just to mark the differences of each petals, of each flowers, how the petals look like and what are the states, like blooming or not blooming. And they are copied, transformed, and, you know, duplicated in sorts of ways. That's why, like, the rendering takes a long time every single, you know, in every single movement. As you can see, just like rendering like that and like that. Oh, this is one of the hardest thing ever, because not just because I have to draw every single flower, but also I have to detail them, every single of them, and that is like some sort of dreadful stuff right there. Another thing is not much different compared to this flower here. Let me just give it a bit of a better window. And there you go, this flower here, you know, they have these, what do you call these, no, that's not pollens, I don't know what you call it. There are also this flower here. Oh, by the way, this is flower B, this is flower 2, and this is the flower 3. Flower 3 is just a simple sunflower. I know, I'm drawing it like very amateurly. These two are just the same as the first one, where you just draw like one flower and then just move it slightly a bit, do some small transformations, copy, duplicate them, place them all, just like that. So with all that said, that's like one of the hardest part on the background wise. Some of them are just simple stuff like clouds, these shadowy clouds, I don't know. These blue skies, just use gradients and you're done. Let's tackle down, let's take a bit of a closer look on some of the complicated parts. Well, actually, there are not much of complicated parts. Let me show you some of the rest. Alright, first of all, some of the complicated parts are just, you know, these arms. Like, I'm really just so annoyed with this arm pose. It's kind of correct, but it still look pretty wrong to me. I don't know. Some of the annoying parts are more of a line factor wise. You know, it's just the uneasiness of using factor drawing software as your main what they call it, your main drawing software. You just have to do draw lines separately. You have to make sure layerings are working as it should be. You know, just all those stuff that I explained in past episodes, especially these color parts. This one is pretty difficult to explain, but essentially you have to cut down the alpha of this color here, and also the lines of it separately. That's where the weird stuff goes on and on. But other than that, they're not much different, other than the fact that I feel like I'm kind of progressing very well in terms of artwork, art style. I don't know. I feel confident about this artwork. I have to say this, the best one that I've ever had, that I've ever drawn so far. So that's all for Blooming Memories. Now let's check out on Alice Cartlett's birthday fan art. This was drawn on 5th April and got it done before the end of 5th April Japan time, which is, it was like, let's say, I think it was like 1 or 30 minutes before the end of 5th April Japan time, or to be exact, Tokyo time. Let's check out on that right away. Alright, here we are in the 5th April, the birthday fan art for Alice Cartlett. As you can see, it has this beautiful writings, "Happy birthday, Alice Cartlett, 5th April 2019, sincerely," yeah, my name here. Now, these fonts aren't factory made, they are from font family. Check this out. Let me just get to, there you go, nicey nice. If I expand this out, you can actually see the font I'm using is called the Perfect Suite. This font is, I've checked it out again, it's free to use, free for personal use, so hopefully I'm not getting in trouble showing this out. But if you want to check out what the font looks like, hopefully I can provide the link to that. But if not, unfortunately I couldn't do anything about that, I'm sorry. But rest assured that this font file will be available in the complete file, in the complete zip file for this one particular artwork, which hopefully I can upload to Synfig forums pretty soon. I'll provide the link as well. Now let's check out a bit of a closer look on this artwork is a bit different, especially for the perspective. This is the right way. This one is really much easier to load. First of all, I don't know why I'm laughing. Her hands is really small compared to her face. This feels so wrong to me, but this is actually correct in terms of how I would see the character in, let's say, my eye, how they look in anime where faces or heads looks much bigger compared to her hands. This is kind of a bit jarring, to be honest. But again, this is a good attempt, I have to say so. And yeah, it's pretty good. I actually have to use the concept art from Kinero Mosaic website and just work my way towards completing the artwork. Not essentially tracing, because I'm not doing tracing at all. Just, you know, look and draw, just like that. You know, and all these cheesy shines. I hope that that is just, you know, good, I guess, cool or anything. Another thing that is pretty special to this artwork is this border. This is not just a ordinary border. Well, to be honest, it's actually pretty much an ordinary border. I got this from searching out the airmail border, or airmail, just airmail, and this is what I get. This is the best one I can get, and it looks pretty good. Doesn't really bad. It's not really bad. It's not super, but I still love it. I'm still okay with it. And I have to be honest, as weird as how her perspective looks, I think I'm still fine with this artwork. This is one of my favorites so far, to be honest. Of course, like number 3 after Blooming Memories. And that's all for this, I gotta say, pretty quick showcase, to be honest with you. But this is not because for no reason. This is also because for several reasons. One, I don't think I can show you a lot of more things regarding to tricks on layering and stuff like that. Two, this is actually gonna be the last video for the format of BtSA. In fact, I actually have explained this in my update video about changing the format of this video and how I will do the take, how I will do the record, how I will do the editing, you know, in my very so-so English language. I gotta say so. Well, let's just get to some final words before we end this video. And there you go, these are the finished artwork for that two Synfig artworks, probably the most recent that I've been working on so far, because a lot of busy things have been going on for, I don't know, several months until now. But hopefully after this one I can get back up again and do even better Synfig artworks than these two in the future. And I gotta say, it's one of the best experience with Synfig so far, despite of all this uneasiness, weirdness, bugs, crashes and stuff like that. After all, if I like it, then I'm going to like it. I don't know what kind of voice words was that, but you know, the point is that I'll keep going with Synfig in. But it doesn't mean I'm just focus on Synfig. I'm gonna go for other drawings of in the future. Hopefully Krita. That's a spoiler there. Haha. But that's all for now. That's all for today's BtSA episode. Thanks for watching, Chisel Love, and I see you again in a new format in next time.